إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed the most truthful of speech and the best of words are the words and the speech of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَشَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. And every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدُ. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, what means you, those of you who believe in Allah, alone without partners, those who you firmly hold to tawheed, and to the correct aqidah of our pious predecessors, the real followers of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ and his sunnah, you are the best of people ever raised up for mankind. Because you enjoin what is correct, what is right, what is pure, from tawheed to the rest of it, and you forbid what is wrong, from shirk and disbelief to all that Islam has forbidden, and you believe in Allah. For the past few weeks we heard the reminder, إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجر كبير أجرا كبيرا. We heard the last few weeks this ayah multiple times reminding us of the value of this message, the speech, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He revealed to His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam over 23 years. That verily this Quran, it guides to that which is right, it guides to that which is most just. So good glad tidings to the believers in the oneness of Allah and those who believe in His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who work deeds of righteousness, that they will have a great reward, meaning paradise. But we must remind ourselves that this book that Allah sent was not a created thing, it was His speech, the final message. You want to save yourself and make it to paradise forever, then you follow this message. This Quran was not just a book for 1 month out of the year. And this is what we constantly need to remind ourselves with day in and day out. Ibadallah, Ramadan came to us as a reminder. A battery recharged because the battery was draining. A life vest because we were drowning in the sea of this dunya and we had nothing to grab onto. And Allah gave us the blessing of Ramadan to save our lives, to redirect our course, to recharge our batteries and remind us of what's important. It was the month of Tawbah, the month of Maghfirah, the month of the revelation of the Qur'an, where the Futihat Abwab As-Sama', where the doors of Jannah were opened, وَأُغْلِقَتْ أَبْوَابَ جَهَنَّمْ, and the doors of the hellfire were closed, وَصُلْسِلَتْ الشَّيَاطِينَ, and the devils were chained up and restrained from the minor devils. This was that month, the masajid were more frequented, charity was given even when we didn't have to ask for it, the Qur'an was being read, and we emulated the best of mankind, the best example, al-uswatul hasana, the best example given for us to role model so that we lead a virtuous and righteous life, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yet we have to ask ourselves. We have to ask ourselves after Ramadan has passed, and it's only been 8 days since we celebrated Eid al-Fitr. Who has undone what they have done in that month? Who has undone that home, that shield, that shelter that they built up during Ramadan? Who will lose the salvation they earned in Ramadan, possibly just for this dunya and following their lusts and their desires? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَلَا تَكُونُ كَالَّتِي نَقَدَتْ غَزْلَهَا مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ أَنْكَاثًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He strikes a message for us by saying, and be not like her who undoes the thread which she has spun after it has become strong. Who is foolish enough to spend 30 days, 30 nights, hours and hours upon minutes upon minutes upon seconds, that whole time, like you're knitting a blanket every second of the day, you didn't even sleep. And then once you get to the end of it, you pull the string out so that it all comes apart. Who is foolish enough to build a home, to lay a foundation, build its walls, put its roof, make it so that it's a secure place of living and a protection, only to then go light it ablaze and put it on fire, making it just ashes? Who is foolish enough to plant some trees, wait for them to grow, wait for them to bear fruit for you to enjoy and suffice yourself with by Allah's permission, to then only go and destroy all those trees and make them to be just ashes? So soon after the days of fasting, of reading the Quran, of seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of standing in qiyam till our feet hurt and we went home tired and tried to sleep just to wake up the next day and worship our Creator again, that the shayateen get released. Wal-Adu al-Mubeen, the major one, Shaytan himself, he sends out his soldiers trying to get you back into evil and sin. So it was a month of struggle, a month of sacrifice, possibly, it can possibly just turn into being a month of hunger and thirst with no reward, no growth towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you continue this struggle after Ramadan passes, if you continue to this upon this path of goodness, trying to please your Creator, this is a sign of acceptance of your fasting. And the opposite is also true, that if you return to sin, this might be a sign that your fasting was for thirst and hunger. The month of fasting was prescribed not for us to look fit, to trim ourselves down, to get into shape, to leave off bad food. It was sent to us as a thing for us to do so that we may achieve taqwa. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said what means. Fasting was prescribed upon you, like it was prescribed upon those before you, so that you may achieve taqwa, that you could be the muttaqoon, that you would fear Allah, keep your duty to Allah, be conscious of Allah, put a barrier between yourself and the punishment of Allah. This is what the fasting, the month of Ramadan, this is what it was supposed to bring in us. That consciousness to fear Allah at all times and distance ourselves from His punishment. Yet some, it just took them hours on the night of Eid or the day of Eid or even a day after or 4 days after or a week after that it all passed, that all the worship, all the self-control goes down the tubes. We forgot, some forgot Allah. Some forgot His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Some forgot the Quran. Some forgot the Masajid. Some forgot our purpose in life and why we were created. And this is the point that we always need to remind ourselves with. Allah said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسِ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah said, I did not create jinn or mankind except to worship Him. So whereas your goal might always just be, I want to enjoy this dunya. The purpose of your life, first and foremost, was for you to worship the one who created you and gave you the blessings and the favors that you could never enumerate. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us, and at the blessing of Ramadan and leaving it, we always remind ourselves to turn our lives around, to increase in worship, to leave off sin, to do good, to correctly practice tawheed, to do our prayers, to pay our zakat, to fix our family ties and the relations between the brothers and the sisters, to uphold our modesty and manners, to live according to the Quran and the authentic sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the question now is this too much to ask? Is it too much to worship Allah and praise Allah and be dutiful to Allah outside of Ramadan? Is it going to kill you or end your life to do what was commanded of you outside of Ramadan? to enjoin what is good and stay away from what Allah forbids? Do you love this dunya more than you love Jannah? A Jannah you can earn for eternity, so that you can be the ones who hears and responds to the call, أُدْخُلُوهَا بِسَلَامٍ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْخُلُودِ. Enter this peace and security, this Jannah forever. This is the day of your eternal life. This is a response, this is a thing we can all hear if we choose to live our life in accordance to the Qur'an and the Sunnah. Again, in Ramadan, we saw true submission, true sacrifice, with charity, with fatigue, with body aches, all for the sake of Allah's face. Sacrificing for Allah's sake, not for this dunya. Do you not know that the Lord of Ramadan is the Lord of this month of Shawwal that we're in? And He's the Lord of Dhul-Qa'dah, and He's the Lord of Dhul-Hijjah, and He's the Lord of Muharram, and He's the Lord of Safar, and He's the Lord of Rabi' al-Awwal and Rabi' al-Thani, and He's the Lord of Rajab, and He's the Lord of Jamada, and He's the Lord of Sha'ban, and the likes of it. Every day, every month of our lives, before our lives, and after we leave from this earth, every one of those belongs to Allah, and He is the Lord of the heavens and the earth during all of those times. So the question is, هل الله عز وجل خصص التوبة في رمضان؟ هل الله عز وجل خصص المغفرة في رمضان؟ هل الله عز وجل خصص الصدقة في رمضان؟ هل الله عز وجل خصص الصلاة في رمضان؟ هل الله عز وجل خصص الصيام في رمضان؟ Did Allah just specify fasting for the month of Ramadan, or praying for the month of Ramadan, or giving charity for the month of Ramadan, or seeking forgiveness during Ramadan? Did Allah just specify that you make repentance, tawbah and nasuha to Allah during Ramadan? No, He did not. Every day of every month is a time for doing all these things. Every day of every month is a time for doing tawbah sincerely to Allah. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. So all of you, O believers, make tawbah to Allah together so that you may be successful. Every day of every month is a time for charity. لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِهِ عَلِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, by no means will you achieve al-birr. In this ayah, the reward of Jannah, the reward of paradise, unless you spend in Allah's cause from what you love the most. And whatever good you spend, Allah knows it well. Allah, in these ayat, He did not specify only during Ramadan. They were made for every second you're breathing, to seek repentance, to seek forgiveness, and to repent to Allah, and to give in charity. From the signs of the acceptance of our fasting is that taqwa was achieved, and we follow up the good of Ramadan with good for the next 11 months, if we're blessed to see any day even beyond today. Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says what means, verily those who say, my Lord is only Allah, and He's the only one I worship, and thereafter, after they have istiqama, they stand firm on this. They stand firm on tawheed, and they abstain from all kinds of evil, and they do all kinds of good. This person, on them shall be no fear, nor shall they grieve. وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ لِمَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا ثُمَّ اهْتَدَى. And Allah said what means, and verily, I am indeed forgiving to the one who repents, who believes in my oneness, and associates nothing in worship with me, and does righteous deeds, and then remains constant in doing them till his death. Standing out firm was not just a command for Ramadan, but for all days of your life. Friday to Friday, Ramadan to Ramadan, every prayer to every prayer. So why then do we stop answering that call when Ramadan ends? Ask yourselves, do you think that one Ramadan is enough for you to make it to Jannah? Do you think one Ramadan is enough to make the Ummah? Do you think that it's fine for you to just be a Ramadan Muslim or a Jum'ah Muslim? Are you okay with the Quran only being read, only being lived out, only being acknowledged? This final message to humanity, the actual speech and the words of our Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan, one of the beauties of our deens is that it is an everyday way of life. So how can we show up in Ramadan and then abandon Allah, abandon His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, abandon this beautiful deen and the truth outside of Ramadan? Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَالْتَنُّرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لِهَدَءٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah says what means, O you who believe, Fear Allah. Keep your duty to Allah. And let every person look to what He has sent forth for tomorrow. For tomorrow, the day you will meet Allah, في يوم كان مقداره خمسين ألف سنة, the day which is 50,000 years long, the sun overhead, you're naked and circumcised. The only thing you're awaiting on that day is the questioning of your Lord. You would throw your own loved ones, your own parents and your own children in the fire to save yourselves. Other than that, you're fleeing. Fear Allah, for verily Allah is all aware of what you do. So Allah deserves to be remembered and acknowledged, and Allah deserves to be the most important aspect of your life at all times. The Sahaba, they have the effect of Ramadan for 6 months. And they prepared the next 5 months for the upcoming month of Ramadan that would follow it if they lived it. So we see two groups. Pick the one you want to be from. The one when Ramadan ends. Actually, during Ramadan, they fasted, they prayed, they gave in charity, they stood in prayers for the Qiyam and the likes of these matters. They did good deeds, but the minute Ramadan leaves, they go back to the life that they had before it came. No change. No change in their heart, no change in their actions, no change in their deeds. Or group two, the one who in Ramadan they did all those good things. They fasted, they prayed, they gave in charity. But the minute Ramadan comes to an end, they're saddened, they're frightened, they're terrified because they tasted halawat al-iman. Man kana Allahu wa rasuluhu ahabba ilayhi mimma sawahuma. The one who tastes the sweetness of faith, one of his characteristics is the one to whom Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam are more beloved to you than anyone and anything else. More than your parents, more than your children, more than your wealth, more than anything you could have. Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam are more beloved. You tasted halawat al-iman. So now they're afraid when Ramadan leaves. What can I do? What can I do to stay upon this goodness? What can I do to stay in a situation where Allah is pleased by my actions? They're afraid for Ramadan to end in fear that they would recoil to sin. Pick the group you want to fall into. Inshallah, we are from the second group who constantly fear Allah and work towards His pleasure. أَقُولَ قَلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرَ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ أَدْعُوا اللَّهَ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, which group do you want to fall into? You can preserve Ramadan by being steadfast and correcting your heart so that you will be safe on the day of resurrection. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهِ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says to us what means thereupon on that day of resurrection, your wealth will not be of any avail to you, nor will your children be of any avail to you, except for the one who brings with Allah, to Allah, afwan, a clean, pure heart, clean and pure of shirk, clean and pure of kufr, of disbelief, clean and pure from nifaq, from hypocrisy. In Sahih al-Bukhari and in the Sahih al-Bukhari al-Muslim, and Nu'man ibn Bashir, he narrates a hadith where the Prophet ﷺ, towards the end of it, he said, وَإِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُبْغَى إِذَا صَلَحَتْ صَلَحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His Messenger ﷺ, he said, indeed, in the body is a morsel, a piece of flesh. If it is sound, if it is good, then the rest of the body is going to be good. But if it's corrupt, then the rest of the body is going to be corrupt. And indeed, that piece of flesh is the heart. Many of us have a heart that beats and it pumps the blood, but it's a heart that's very dark or very doomed because of what really resides in it from hypocrisy and the likes of those matters. Aisha radiallahu anha, she narrated that our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, اِكْلَفُوا مِنَ الْعَمَلِ مَا تُطِيقُونَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَمَلُّ حَتَّى تَمَلُّ وَإِنَّ أَحَبَّ الْعَمَلِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَدْوَمُهُ عَفْوًا وَإِنْ قَلْ وَكَانَ إِذَا عَمِلَ عَمَلًا أَثْبَتَهُ. This hadith, which is sahih in the Sunan of Abi Dawood, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, choose actions that you're capable of doing. Someone like me is not going to choose to climb Mount Everest or one of those tall mountains. It's not capable, and I'm not capable of it. Choose actions you can do. Pick things to do that you know you're capable of. Because Allah does not grow weary until you do. The acts that are most pleasing to Allah, that He loves the most and He will reward the most, are those which are done continuously, even if they're little. Never belittle a good deed. Because the one who even smiles at every brother or sister he meets, the one who just saves that, gives that smile for charity, and does it constantly, even if they're saddened or anxious or depressed or whatever it means, this action to Allah is very loved. Because it's a continuous deed. Whenever he began an action, he would do it continuously. Tawheed is the key to the acceptance of our good deeds and the key to earning Allah's rahmah. That mercy is what's needed to get to Jannah. Your good deeds, even if you did not sin, are not enough for you to enter Jannah. They're not enough. We need the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters in Islam, it is not only the case with the one who worships Allah in Ramadan. You have to worship Him as every day was Ramadan to you. مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٍ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Allah says what means, whoever works righteous deeds, male or female, while he or she is a true believer in Tawheed, verily to him or her, we will give a good life in this world. They'll have respect, they'll have contentment, they'll have halal provisions, and we shall pay them certainly with a reward in proportion to the best of what they used to do with Jannah in the hereafter. So come on, my brothers and sisters, we cannot just show up for Ramadan. Be true to yourselves, call yourselves to account. Look at yourself in the mirror and ask, did I give sadaqah today? Because I did in Ramadan. Did I fast today? Because I did in Ramadan. Did I read the book of Allah today? Because I did in Ramadan. Question yourselves and always call yourselves to account. Our Prophet ﷺ, he cried, Allahumma ummati, Allahumma ummati. Oh Allah, my ummah, my ummah, my ummah, my ummah. So concerned that we would be lost to this dunya and become slaves of our desires and leave off that deen. Leave off the deen, leave off the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People during Ramadan were attending the prayers in flocks. And the minute Ramadan leaves, half the people are gone. And then a week later, half of that half are now gone. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, if you know that 2 plus 2 equals 4, if you show $27 to a kid, he'll know that it is more than $1. If they can understand this concept, we're capable of understanding the concept. The reward for praying jama'ah in the masjid is 25 or 27 times the reward of you praying it by yourself in your home. So where are we losing out? Our Prophet ﷺ, he said, مَنْ صَلَّى الْعِشَاء فِي جَمَاعَةً فَكَأَنَّمَا قَامَ نِصْفَ اللَّيْلِ وَمَنْ صَلَّى الصُّبْحِ فِي جَمَاعَةً فَكَأَنَّمَا قَامَ اللَّيْلَ كُلَّهُ. Our Prophet ﷺ, he said, whoever prays Salat al-Isha, it's at 10 p.m. If you come and pray in jama'ah in the masjid, you're done before Taraweeh used to end. The Taraweeh, the Qiyam used to end at 10:30. You're done way before that. Whoever comes and prays it in jama'ah, it will be written for you like you stood up half the prayer, half the night in prayer. So even if you go home at 10:15 when the prayer is done, and you pray your sunnah with them, you go to sleep, Allah will write that you stood up in prayer from 10 p.m. all the way till 2 p.m. And guess what? If you come to Fajr, to Subh, Salat al-Subh, in Jama'ah, it will be as if you stood up the whole night in prayer. Yani, backed up against the Salat al-Isha being prayed in Jama'ah. For you to do what? You did it for a month. You proved it to Allah that you could get in your car, drive here, even though the whole day you were lacking sleep, you were lacking food and drink, you were at work, you're tired, but you did it. Why? Taraweeh Qiyam is a sunnah. You didn't have to do it. You could have prayed it at your home. You could have not prayed it at all. You're not deficient in anything if you don't do it. There's no sin upon you. But if you abandon the congregational prayer for the men, and this is a message for the sisters, because you have a voice, you can tell your husbands, get up and go to the masjid. You can take your sons to the masjid. You can encourage your fathers to go to the masjid, and the likes of these matters. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, do not make a mockery of this deen, a mockery of Allah, a mockery of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah does not need us. But if we think that He cannot see that we came for a month and then He doesn't see what happens outside of Ramadan, you're fooling yourself. You're the fool. You cannot fool the one who has all-encompassing knowledge. When we worship Allah outside of Ramadan, like we worship Him in Ramadan, when we attend the daily prayers, like we attend the Fajr prayer, the Jum'ah prayer, Then we will see this ummah be rescued from its vices. We will see this ummah be rescued from its challenges and trials. You want to help the people of Palestine? You want to help the people of Afghanistan? You want to help the Muslims, Afwan, of Afghanistan? You want to help the Muslims of Burma? You want to help the Muslims of China? You want to help the Muslims all across the globe? You can do so by attending your prayers in the masajid. This is how you will start getting that help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we could be the ummah that Allah said was khayr ummatin ukhrajat lin nas. Then we could be that ummah that was the best of nations that was raised up to mankind. As a reminder for us, because we're in the month of Shawwal, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam man sama Ramadan thumma tba'ahu sittan min Shawwal fa ka'annama sama ad-dahr. Rawahu Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, whoever fasts the month of Ramadan and he follows it up, or she follows it up, with 6 days of fasting in the month of Shawwal, 29, 30 days, pick your days, except do not single out Jum'ah. You cannot say, I'm just going to fast Friday if it's an optional thing. You have to piggyback it with Thursday, and according to some of the ulama, Saturday, from the ulama who didn't think it was prohibited to also not fast on Saturdays outside of Ramadan. So whoever fasts 6 days of Shawwal, after they have completed their fast of Ramadan, so if you have any that you missed, you should make them up first, then this person, it will be written for him or her as they fasted the whole year. Who's capable of fasting the whole year? Most of us, no way. But this is the reward Allah magnifies and increases for His servants. And guess what? If we had any deficiencies in our fasting, it's these extra fasting that will make up for it. Just like the nawafil prayers, they will make up for the shortcoming of our fardh prayers. So if you can fast 6 days in this month, any days, it doesn't have to be in a row. They don't have to be all six together. You can do Monday, Thursday, Monday, Thursday, Monday, Thursday for the next 3 weeks. Then it will be written for you as if you fasted the whole year. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this was a reminder to myself and a reminder to you, and for you to remind your families with it, that we need to worship Allah, Rabbul Alameen, the Lord of the heavens and the earth. He's the Lord of every month, of every day, of every minute, of every second of our lives. Worship Him as if every day is Ramadan. And don't just make yourself those who you build something strong because of what you do during Ramadan, only to then destroy it the minute Ramadan has left. Salat al-Isha, 10 p.m. Just pray the fard here. The sunnah is more rewarding in your home if you want to pray it then. And then go home. And you've fulfilled something that will strengthen the bonds, the ties of the communities, of the ummah. And then maybe we will be elevated and under that banner with our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the day of resurrection to be خير أمة أخرجت من الناس, the best nation that was raised up for mankind. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.